And the next phylum we are going to study now is the Aspidehelminths. 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 And these are also called as Nematihelminths. Nematihelminths. And these organisms are commonly called as nematodes. These are commonly called as nematodes or roundworms. They are also called as roundworms. If we take the transverse section of these organisms, we find circular shaped body. So that's why these are called as roundworms. Okay. Habitat. See, most of the organisms, these are also parasitic in nature, but they are also found in aquatic form. They are also found in aquatic and they are also terrestrial forms, aquatic, terrestrial, and most of them are parasites. That means endoparasites. Most of them are endoparasites and few of them are free living. Okay. And these organisms are showing bilateral symmetry, and triploblastic. These are triploblastic and these are pseudo coelomates. Pseudo coelomates. Okay. And the organisms which belongs to the lower phylum, like the Ctenophora, the Porifera, Cnidaria, okay, and Platyhelminthes, all organisms, they are acoelomates. But these are the first organisms, they are showing pseudo-coelomates. Here, see, this is the ectoderm and this is the endoderm. Here, the body cavity is scattered like pouches. Here, okay, true coelom is absent here. Okay, the coelom is scattered like this. Body cavity is scattered like pouches. Okay, so that's why the name pseudo-coelomates. True coelom is absent in these organisms. And then, body plan is tube within a tube. Body plan is found. So these are the first organisms which shows tube within a tube body plan. So these are the first organisms showing tube within a tube body plan. That means they contain complete digestive system. Complete digestive system. That means digestive system contains two openings. Anterior and posterior opening is found. So through the anterior opening, the food is taken in, and through the posterior opening, the waste products will come out. So digestive system or alimentary canal, it contains two opening, okay, anterior and posterior. Such type of body plan is called as tube within a tube body plan. So these are the first organisms that are showing tube within a tube body plan. Okay. And so these, the body wall of these organisms, body wall of these organisms, body wall of these organisms made up of three layers. Made up of three layers. Okay. The first layer, it is made up of cuticle. First layer is made up of cuticle. And second one, epidermis. Epidermal layer is formed. And third one is muscular layer. and third one is muscular layer. Okay, and epidermis, it is the cells which are found in this layer, they are multinucleated. Okay, and that's why it is called as syncytial layer. It can also called as syncytial layer because of the presence of multinuclei, because the cells are multinucleated. And muscular layer, it is made up of longitudinal muscles. Okay, and this is about the body wall. And these organisms exhibit, organ system level of organization. Organ system level of organization we can see in these organisms. And here they show, these organisms show sexual dimorphism. So this is also very important. That means, what is the meaning of sexual dimorphism? See, the meaning of this word is sexes are separate. That means we can easily, that means male and females are separate. Okay, sexual dimorphism means sexes are separate. The meaning is male and female organisms are separate. Okay, and here I am going to draw the diagram of male and female worms. Okay. We can easily identify by external features and also by the internal organ system. Okay, so we can easily differentiate male and females. So females are slightly longer than males here. Okay, take for example Ascaris. So it is commonly called as roundworm. In this Ascaris, we can easily identify the male from the female. We can easily distinguish male from the female because males are short in their length and females are slightly longer than the male. Okay, and the body is like this. See, at the posterior end, a slightly curved body is found in males. Okay, at the posterior. So this is the anterior end. Anterior end contains, so this is mouth. Okay, and this is an external opening is found here. Okay, so that is called as excretory pore here. So excretory pore is formed. So this is male Ascaris. Okay, and here one more opening is there. So this is called as cloaca. So cloaca, it is the common opening for both excretory and reproductive opening. Okay, here digestive and reproductive opening. Cloaca, it is common for both. Common opening for excretory products and also reproductive products. Okay, see, cloaca is a structure. So it is a common opening for both excretory and the reproductive systems. Okay, so it is a common opening for both excretory and reproductive system here. So that structure is called as cloaca. And here one more structure is found. So this structure is called as excretory pore, and here at the posterior end we find one more opening, so that is called as anus, and slightly above the anus one more opening is there, so that is called as genital pore. Genital pore. See here, we can easily identify the males and the females by seeing the length and also by seeing some morphological structure. See, cloaca is common opening for both digestive and reproductive system. But here, the anus is the opening for the digestive system, okay, and genital pore is opening for the reproductive system. So here, cloaca is not found in the females. Okay, and copulatory cecum is found above the cloacal aperture. So like this we can easily identify the males and the females, easily distinguish the males and the females. So that's why the name, they are exhibiting sexual dimorphism. Okay. See, excretion is through excretory tube and excretory pore is formed now in these organisms. So through the excretory pore, the waste will come out. Okay. And next, reproductive system. So most of them are hermaphrodites. Sorry, see, the sexes are separate. We have already seen, isn't it? Sexes are separate. The sexual dimorphism we can see. See, cross fertilization here takes place. Cross fertilization. Fertilization is internal here. Fertilization internal. Internal fertilization takes place. Development may be direct or indirect. Development may be direct or indirect development we can see. Okay. And these organisms exhibit one more special phenomenon called as UTV. Okay. So UTV, see, it is the phenomenon in which number of cells are fixed in each system. It may be digestive system or it may be excretory system. Okay. See, number of cells in each organ system, it is fixed. Okay. See, from the birth, okay, at the time of birth, how many number of cells are present, the same number of cells are going to maintain until their death. Okay. So such phenomenon is called as UTV. Okay. Number of cells. Number of cells are fixed in each organ system. So such phenomenon is called as UTV. Okay. And next, they are monogenetic. They are monogenetic. Meaning is, see, these organisms have only one host in their life cycle. That means they complete their life cycle. See, in parasitic worms, they complete their life cycle in one host. In one host. Such organisms are called as monogenetic organisms. Okay. In case of parasites only. Okay. In case of parasite or parasitic worms, they complete their life cycle in one host. Okay. So such phenomenon is called as monogenetic phenomena. And these are, some of them are endoparasites and they feed on undigested food. Endoparasites feeds on undigested food. Okay. And the infection of these organisms takes place almost in small kids. Okay. Because they are roaming around here and there, no? So they are not properly washing their hands. So like this, see, through the contaminated food and water, so these get enter into the digestive system of the organisms of the animals. Okay, so like this, they get enter digestive system. Okay, so in almost around the 10 years, below 10 years old kids, so these infections are common. Okay, and common examples: Ascaris lumbricoides. Ascaris lumbricoides. Okay, commonly it is called as roundworm. It causes a disease called as ascariasis. Ascariasis disease will come. Okay. So intestinal perforations will occur. Okay. And some stomach pain will come from this disease. Okay. So these are some of the symptoms we can see in ascariasis. Okay. So ascariasis is a disease that is caused by the organism Ascaris lumbricoides. And Eucheria bancrofti. Eucheria bancrofti. Filarial worm. This is commonly called as filarial worm. And another one is ankylostoma. Ankylostoma. So these are the common examples for the phylum Ascaris. Okay, it is commonly called as hookworm. So this is about the general characteristic features of the phylum Ascaris. Here we are going to concentrate on, so these are pseudo coelomates. So these are the first organisms they are showing, pseudo coelom. And this is also one of the most unique characteristic feature we can see after the platyhelminthes. See, tube within a tube body plant starts from these organisms, and as we continue to study the further phylums, so it is constantly maintained. Okay, so these are the first organisms they are having tube within a tube body plant. That means complete digestive system, complete alimentary canal is found in these organisms. Excretion is through excretory tube, and the waste will come out through the excretory pore. Okay, and for sexes are separate here. Sexual dimorphism they exhibit. We can easily identify the males and females by observing the morphological features. Okay. And fertilization is internal, development may be direct or indirect. And this is important, monogenetic. Parasites completes their life cycle in one host, so that is called as monogenetic. And utility is the phenomenon in which the number of cells are going to be fixed in each organ system. So these are some of the examples that are given. Okay. So this is about the general characteristic feature of Ascaris. In the next video, we shall discuss about the next phylum, that is Annelida.